caring for them. So just appreciation for who does what, etc. is quite there, impactful on people's psyche. And certainly in arena here, in India and elsewhere, you can see, did you see that from Jalandhar or somewhere that they could see Himalayas, 204 kilometers. Isn't that amazing? They're sitting in Punjab between Himalayas because the air is so clean. In Delhi and Mumbai, everywhere, the air has been cleaner. And all these, you see animals coming out, ducks coming out, all these pictures being floated around and WhatsApp. But it's in what's you know, human beings may be in a zoo right now, trapped in building, but the other animals are sort of being freed. You've even seen tigers come out, right? So what looks like a problem for one can be an opportunity for another. New treatments are coming out, pharma companies are booming. You can see the Amazon and such online commerce companies, they are booming. There's telehealth, there's tele-education. Education is ripe for disruption. Health is ripe for disruption, especially in the U.S., one-fifth of the economy, and we don't necessarily have that higher quality of health care compared to the expense we pay. But we could maybe transform it from a disease care system to a real health care and prevention system using Ayurveda, the Yunani medicine, Chinese medicine, and everything else, which is low cost and non-invasive and no side effects, and something that's been tested for thousands of years. For competitive advantage in business, it can be a game changer. You see that, in the geopolitics, if you start from there, China sees us as an opportunity that while America is grappling with these problems, India sees an opportunity to get back into the manufacturing game against China, which may be distracted because of geopolitical reasons. But when some crisis happens, it does shake up things, and it's important that you just begin to keep moving, keep going. That's kind of the life. Life is to keep going on, whatever happens. As I say, life is not so important as to what happens, but how you react to it or what you do with what happens. I know it's like easy to say, but that's what some of these very smart people who become extremely successful are going to do. And then it's generating a lot of applications, apps, and other online portals and various other applications to analyze the data, to monitor the data, track the data, look at what kind of applications are coming. And with this data, a lot of artificial intelligence and machine learning applications are coming, which can access this data, trained into new models, so they can do a lot of work for us. So that was kind of the thing, a big opportunity. As you can see picture, there's also the time, because of time saved from this and that. Group certainly, sit and read and reflect, go in inner, meditate. This is very, very important to meditate and be comfortable with ourselves. Biggest immunity is knowing ourselves. You are a little swastha. Swastha means healthy. What does swastha mean? Swastha means self. Swastha means situated. When you are settled within yourself, when your consciousness, your awareness is back in yourself, then you're healthy. COVID cannot catch you, I think, for the most part. No disease can catch you if you are healthy. And that is not. It's just being, bring your attention center. Anyway, that's my commentary on so many opportunities. I'm sure so many young people among you and others who would be looking at it and say, what can I do to create opportunities? Social entrepreneurship is a big deal. Now, jumping straight into the whole data, whole big data. What is big data? I hope you can read this slide. So there are four parts, which is big data. What is big data? It is an all-inclusive term that refers to extremely large, very far data that cannot be managed with traditional data management. It doesn't.
Mm-hmm.